Hey everybody, and welcome to the ExpressVPN.com YouTube channel. My name's Lauren, I'm the head of comms, and I'm delighted today to be here chatting with members of our security and engineering teams to talk about our latest server upgrade. It might sound boring, but trust me, it's going to be interesting. Let's dive in with the guys now. So let's start with you, Aaron. Tell me about what you do at ExpressVPN.
My team's job is basically to ensure the security of ExpressVPN as a whole, for our customers, for our employees, as well as our software and our applications and services. We do this in many, many different ways. A few ways we do that are through penetration tests to basically test and validate the security of our products and services. But we have engineers, security-oriented engineers, that work with our developers to ensure that security is incorporated throughout the entire lifecycle and development process to make sure that we are delivering products and services that are up to our security standards. And finally, we also have a group in the Security Operations Center who are dedicated to monitoring our systems and services to look for bad guys trying to attack us. We need to do this to make sure that if someone's trying to attack us, we can identify it and work to respond to it to ensure the security of our company and thus in turn, the security of our customers, our products and services.
Thanks, Aaron. And Brendan, welcome. What do you do with ExpressVPN?
I was one of the key people that was part of the team that designed Trusted Server, mostly focusing around the operating system side of things, because that's basically one of my key hobbies in life is playing with operating systems. As boring as that sounds, that's the key part of Trusted Server, and that's how we ended up with InRAM, which was an industry-changing technology.
Not only that, it's now the industry standard, so
yeah.
What a turnaround.
The most important part is it was the first InRAM operating system in the entire industry. Obviously, that was very game-changing and amazing for user security, but it's not the end where we stopped. We just didn't say, in memory, we're done. There's a lot of other things now that Trusted Server encompasses. It's an engineering mindset. It's security first and foremost. Verification, two-step processes, hardware tokens, two people reviews. It's a mindset, not just an in-RAM product.
We're here having a chat because ExpressVPN is going through a major server infrastructure upgrade. What does this upgrade consist of?
The hardware modernization project consists of two parts, data centers and obviously the servers in them. The data centers are also a big part of this. Obviously, security is a massive thing for what we do, but also having quality data centers is a massive part of performance, and we can't make the most use of modern hardware in a bad data center. So we looked at things in data centers like peering agreements, transit agreements, upstream bandwidths, how big the data centers are, how secure they are, do they apply the modern security standards like man traps and videos and PIN codes and all that. And once we were happy with that, we decided that now we need to go back and engineer what's the best server to put inside those data centers. So the team took back a few steps and figured out what our exact requirements are. We can do that holistically more so than other providers because we control the operating system, which is Trusted Server, and we also control the VPN protocol, which is Lightway. So it was very easy for us to engineer our exact needs and requirements to make this modernization project work better.
For the people who love to read the numbers on the side of a box, what are the specs and models of the kinds of servers that we're investing in?
We mostly use Intel hardware because it's more common at the moment. That's obviously could change in the future. But what we're standardizing on is more of a core count and memory count rather than a specific processor. Obviously, data centers do vary, but so for a core count, we're aiming between 20 at a minimum to 32 as a maximum, because any more than that, we found it was not really that beneficial, or we hit other different bottlenecks in servers. In terms of RAM, we've hit 128 gig up from 16. And we've standardized on a minimum of 10G network cards. But again, because we control the entire stack end to end, we're also looking at 40G and 100G connectivity later on.
What do we expect the impact is going to be on our users?
The major thing most users will notice is when they go about their normal daily use of the VPN, wherever they are worldwide, doesn't matter about location, they get a consistent experience. Their videos work, their music doesn't stutter, things just carry on as if they weren't on a VPN. We've decided to standardize infrastructure, make things more consistent around the world so that users don't have to pick a specific location to do something or find out through back channels which clusters are the powerful ones to connect to. All of our stuff is equal and very powerful. Those of us who live in areas with really fast internet connections can push more data. That's great. That's one of the upsides of 10G. But one of the real key benefits for everyone across the entire world is, we have less contention on the server. So a 10G network card can hold more users, transfer data easier. We're not blocking on stuff. We're not, you know, limiting user sessions. We're basically ensuring all our users get a fair experience. Like, there are users out there with 1G connections at home, and that's great, but not everyone has that. So it's not necessarily being the fastest by having a 10G network card. It's also ensuring our contention levels are low and the user experience is fair and balanced.
And what was the state of the server network before that? I mean, we've been around for 13 years. So I imagine technology's changed a lot in that time.
Yeah, 13 years ago, technology was very different. Like, we're talking about servers that had 4 cores or maybe 2, not much memory, 1 gigabit network cards were normal. And now we're talking about servers that have 20 plus cores, 128 gig of memory, 10G network cards. So a lot has changed. Servers have become a lot more powerful. We're able to consolidate our infrastructure a bit more, which is great for the environment. It's also great for the business. And it also means less moving parts for us to manage, which means less potential security holes.
Isn't it the case that it's better to have more servers?
No, it's not anymore, because when we think about servers now, we've got servers with 20 cores at a minimum, or we could even scale it up to more if we needed to. Of course, we've engineered the best amount of core count for our servers to ensure that we've got the right hardware. So server counts don't matter as much as they used to. Having more servers, well, if you're not optimizing your stack properly, you're probably not making use of the entire server anyway. We've engineered our stack and selected the proper servers so we get the most utilization out of them without over or under utilizing them, including peak times like F1 events or sporting events or other big things like that.
Nice. So it's really about better understanding the load that's going through all of the servers to manage congestion and traffic and make sure that all of our users are having a great experience.
That's exactly it. So we've tried to engineer that as best as possible because, again, we own the entire stack from trusted server to Lightway. We can look into that and control every aspect of it, which is a major thing we have over our competitors.
Nice. The other thing that I think is really important that I heard you talking about the other day was increasing the number of VPN instances.
Correct. So again, coming back to the core count and memory count, because servers are more powerful, we've got more instances on each server. The upside of that means that each server can better balance its users across, reduce contention ratios. And with things like 10G network cards or 40 and 100G network cards in the future that we'll start using, it basically means that all of our users get a much more fair experience. They're not fighting for resources, whether that be process or network bound.
And for those people out there who aren't up to date with their latest VPN protocols, tell me about Lightway.
Lightway, again, is developed in-house by ExpressVPN. Using the same engineering mindset that Trusted Server was developed. So again, it's for our needs first, security first, ensuring that we've developed something that works best for our users.
What does this mean in terms of the need to optimize our servers?
By having Lightway, by having Trusted Server so tightly coupled, means that we can better tune the hardware, better understand how to set up the operating system, and that means better utilizing the fancier hardware we've bought, like more memory, better network cards, 10G cards, 40G cards, because we have Lightway. We're fully in control of how Lightway works and we understand it because we wrote it.
I think another thing that I really like when it comes to ExpressVPN is how intentional we are about the new features that we add or the changes that we make. We go through a very thorough planning and investigation process to make sure that it's going to enhance our users' experience and make sure that it's not something that we need to roll back in a hurry or reconsider. When we do something, we do it definitively. And yes, generally speaking, it becomes the new standard for the industry, just like Trusted Server has.
Yep, that's the engineering mindset that I really love about ExpressVPN. And Trusted Server shows that, Lightway shows that, the hardware modernization project shows that. We've engineered things properly. We've thought about our requirements, needs, and users' demands and loads. We just didn't go out there and buy the biggest, shiniest thing because bigger is always better. We've engineered the stack for our needs and our customers' needs first.
One of the other things, along with audits and technology investment that we focus on in order to make sure that we're on the cutting edge, is actually working with the cybersecurity community of researchers to have a bug bounty. Aaron, you're from the cybersecurity team and your team oversees our bug bounties. Can you tell me a little bit more about our Trusted Server bug bounty and how that works?
Our bug bounty program is a fantastic program where we interface with a lot of security researchers globally who can work to submit potentially security vulnerabilities related to our services, our offerings, our products, where we then evaluate and investigate those. And if they turn out to be legitimate, we actually give them a monetary reward. And then we immediately go and fix those issues that they identified. I would also like to highlight that we recently went ahead and created a $100,000 bug bounty targeted at Trusted Server itself. The reason why this bounty is so large, because it just goes to showcase our commitment and dedication to Trusted Server, all the effort that we put into making it an amazing secure product. And then finally, we just basically saying, hey, if you find something, great. We want to know so that we can fix it. But simultaneously, we're also saying, we're giving you so much money because we think we're very confident that you will not be able to find anything.
There's been a lot of information given today. And if viewers walk away with just one thing to remember, what would you like them to remember?
I'd like them to remember that ExpressVPN engineers the best solutions. We put a lot of thought and effort into engineering time, security time, and working out what's best for our users. That obviously takes a lot of time, but we really believe it pays off to get the right thing out there, especially when we're talking about security. You can't make mistakes here. This is, you know, people's personal privacy. We've got to get it right the first time, which means we engineer it first time right.
One of the things I heard one of our team leaders say last week is that quality equals future speed. And I love that idea that you invest in making sure it's right up front and it pays off down the line as well as immediately upon rollout.
Yes, I agree.
Well, Aaron and Brendan, thanks so much for being here and sharing more about Trusted Server and the hardware upgrades that ExpressVPN is implementing right now.
No worries. Thank you.